This is Match Game 74, and it's production number 0240. And it's take one. Now. Get ready to match the star. Jimmy Walker. Brett Summer. Charles Nelson Riley. Joyce Boulafont. Richard Dawson. And Loretta Switz. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rutter.
My father, Lloyd George. Lloyd George.
Thank you, Johnny Olson. Thank you, Assemble Kooks, one and all. I'm delighted to have you here at Match Game 74. Well, I guess you're ready. Your motors are going already. Hers is all set, wound up, and going.
Perpetual.
I see. You're all set there. How's the sailor doing up there?
He's asleep.
I'm fine, Gene.
Oh, thanks a lot. All right. Now, would all of you celebrated folk give a brisk round of applause to our two players, Beth Horning and June Rose? Would you do that?
Beth is the current champion. She's won one game. She has $100.
And she's being challenged by June Rose. And at the end of round one, the score is 1-0 in favor of our current champion. And we're about to begin round two. Ladies, are you ready for that?
Ready.
Good. We'll begin that right after you have a look at these commercials. There's a lady sleeping here in the second row. And I'm very upset about it. It's a big hit show.
Show who they are. Look.
And she's awake now.
You left
she's
call,
pretending
sir.
She's enjoying the whole show, and she's been asleep all the time. But look at the guy next to her with the sand in his eyes. How can you sleep through the number one show on television, madam? Hello there. I'm sorry about that, lady, but we'll go on anyway. Now, June, this is the beginning of round two, and it's up to you to make a selection here.
I'm going to switch to A this time and give that.
You're going to switch?
Yeah, I'll have it to.
I suspected that of you. Here we go. Everybody, please. Ben, who worked for Consumer Reports, said, "We had a wonderful time at the office. We spent the entire day testing blank."
Would you swing that in ragtime, dear?
Ben, who worked for Consumer Reports, said, "We had a wonderful time at the office. We spent the entire day testing blank." You're finished. You're the best.
I'm going to join those two people down there and sleep. Yes.
Do you live in the neighborhood, sir? Madam? Are the two sleepers together? Are you together? You mean you don't know, you don't even know each other? Let's get out of here now.
I think that's class when we can show people sleep on our show.
All right, they're all set over there, so I'll give it to you here. Ben, who worked for Consumer Reports, said, "We had a wonderful time at the office. We spent the entire day testing blank." June?
Testing. I can't think of what they were testing.
They loved it. They had a wonderful day at the office. We spent the entire day testing...
Testing the secretaries.
She finally thought of it, didn't she? Yeah.
I wish I'd said that.
Yeah, Jimmy, what did you say? She said the secretaries.
Of course, how silly of us all to even think anything else.
Yes. Yeah.
Testing products.
Products, yeah.
Get this crowd out of here!
Yeah. Okay, Brett, what do you say?
Do you know that I looked at his answer and I didn't have my glasses on, and I thought he said testing dropouts. Dumb answer. Yeah.
Not as bad as products.
Not as quite as dumb as mine. I said Gordon's vodka. Now, I don't want the vodka.
Well, wait a minute.
I didn't finish my commercial.
Charles.
They won't call you or get in touch with you because Gordon's doesn't make vodka.
May we see your answer,
yes,
sir?
Yes, I think this is a match. I hope so for England's sake, my dear.
I hope so, no.
Broads.
There it is.
you say?
No,
you.
I wouldn't say that, Joyce.
It's the nicest compliment I ever had.
What do you say?
Well, I think before they tested the broads,
yes,
they tested the booze.
The booze. Testing booze. There.
I'm glad you asked me that.
Yeah, what?
Could you repeat the question?
The question, had a wonderful time at the office. We spent the entire day testing.
Oh, yes. I said George's answer, booze.
And you hit her right in the nose.
Yeah, well, that's what happens when you wake up.
Better than elsewhere.
Booze, Loretta. She's looking for secretaries.
I couldn't think of anything that wouldn't get bleeped. And I thought of products, which I didn't want to write. So I looked at the camera and I thought TV sets she would say maybe, but she didn't.
Didn't say TV sets at all.
You thought of it though.
I thought of it.
Did you hear that?
I did.
So now, Beth, you're in a good spot. It's a tie score. You need one match to win the game. Everyone plays except Brett, and here it is. Hey, Ray said, King Kong always carries me in his hand because once he let me ride on his blank and I bit him. Hello, cutie. Hey, Ray said, King Kong always carries me in his hand because once he let me ride on his blank and I bit him.
Once more?
Yes. Faye Ray, you remember her?
I remember Faye Ray.
King Kong always carries me in his hand.
Charles, come on.
Because once he let me ride on his blank and I bit him. Big Brother is watching.
I don't know what Charles would have been if he lived.
Okay. All ready. Over there, Beth, it's up to you now. Faye Ray said King Kong always carries me in his hand because once he let me ride on his blank and I bit him.
I hope it's Nick.
What's that?
Nick.
Ride. Once he let me ride on his neck and I bit him. Well, that's a little Count Dracula-ish, isn't it, Jimmy?
Of course it's ish.
Ah.
Ish, get it? Ish kebab. No, I said nose.
You're right in his nose and I bit him.
Who is this crowd? Who brought this people in here?
What did you say, Brett?
I didn't write, darling.
Oh, you didn't.
I laid out the stuff.
Okay, all right, Charles.
I said back.
Back. A very inspired answer, if I've ever seen one. Joyce?
I said right on his finger.
On his finger? Well, we're getting some dumb answers to this dumb question.
Now let's examine the question carefully.
Yeah. Well,
it's a
dumb question.
Oh, yeah, Faye Ray and a gorilla.
Yeah.
That's an unnatural act in most countries. But anyway, I said,
I rode on the shoulder.
There's a good answer.
Well, thank you.
Oh, you very always say a dumb question.
No, that's a good answer, shoulder, because then now what do you say?
Monkey on the back and just reversed it and put the girl
on the monkey's back. Oh, I see. Okay.
Now I'll bet you very wish I were playing.
So at the end of round two, at the end of the game, we have a tie score. That means we're going to have to go to a tiebreaker. And we'll tell you about that right after we tell you about this. Oh, boy, here we go. Now, we got a tiebreaker. What happens to the tiebreaker is we got to wipe the slate clean here and push a button and reveal a tie-breaking question for each of our players. And the one who scored the most will be the winner. June, would you make a selection?
I'll go to B this time.
All right, B it is. A tiebreaker. Everybody play.
Butcher.
Tony said. Tony said. You should have been at Scarface's birthday party. When they gave him the cake, instead of blowing out the candles, Scarface blanked them out. See how good he is? He's the hoist. All right. All ready? There we go. June, Tony said you should have been at Scarface's birthday party. When he gave him the cake, instead of blowing out the candles, Scarface blanked him out.
Shut him out.
Shut him out. She said shut. What say you?
Over here is what I say. I like that, you know? We'll do something for you, you know what I mean? You're a nice kid.
Shot.
Shot is the man. There's one. All right, Brett?
Yes, dear.
You participate because it's a tiebreaker.
My old butcher's name was Harold. And I say God save the Queen. Shot.
And Charles.
I say another shot, really.
Another shot. Instead of blowing out the candle, Scarface blanked them out. What do you say, Joyce?
Oh, dear, you couldn't eat it because he stomped them out.
He stomped them out, yeah. Right there, Richard.
She's got to stop dyeing her hair.
That was a good answer. Stomped out is good.
Yeah, nothing wrong in that.
Shot.
All right. Loretta, are you having a good time?
Was that a question or a statement? Yes, I'm having a wonderful time.
Good.
Shot him.
All right, shot him. That's five for you. Now, you need five to tie, six to win. The old organ grinder got so hungry he ate his blank. Yes, of course. Listen carefully as I read it now to Beth. There it is. I'll do it to two of you. The old... Read it out loud there so everybody can hear it.
The old organ grinder got so hungry he ate his monkey.
Monkey. To you, sir. What do you say? Your lips are moving, but I don't hear any sound coming out.
You didn't say monkey. I'm going to push you off that chair.
She's a little hostile occasionally, but she's all right.
You mean it's on Kid Blackness?
That's right. It's all on your shoulders.
Monkey.
Monkey. Okay. There's one. Brad, I assume...
Well, I myself didn't say monkey. I said monkey.
Of course you said monkey. Charles?
The old-timer to my left.
What does the old-timer say?
Why can't you just simply show your card and smile?
Yeah, that's it. Very well done. Okay. Now, Joyce?
Instead of grinding his organ, he ground up his monkey.
There you go. Okay. Richard?
One more monkey, then it will be a tied game again. Is
that's
that right?
Right. It's up to you to tie
you
the game.
You mean to say it's all on Kid Whiteness?
Well, monkey.
Monkey.
That's what I mean to tell you. And I mean to tell you.
Now, the bad news.
Got a tie score now. And you can break the tie. Or not break the tie, Loretta. It's all up to you.
All right. Now, does everyone recall when I asked you to repeat the question?
Get it over with quickly.
And so what I thought you said was, what did the old organ grinder's monkey do when he got hungry? And I wrote, eat his organ grinder. I did not understand.
We have to play another whole round because of...
The doctor says it's time for your bath.
Sooner or later, we gotta come back to this whole mess and finish it up. I don't know when, but you can... Hello there, friends. Now, since this game ended in the tie, we gotta wipe the slate clean all over again and push the tiebreaker button, and lo and behold, there are two more tiebreaker questions. This is the last one, Lisa. This isn't going anywhere, you see. It's really fixed and solid. So, ladies, all right, would you make a selection?
I'll have number B again.
B, all right. B it is. Everybody plays. Hilda called to Sally. Hey, this phone call's for you. There's a guy blanking at the other end. Let me do that for you.
Who wrote that question is the first question I'm going to ask.
Call to Sally. Hey, Sally, this phone call's for you. There's a guy blanking at the other end. Or there's a guy blanking at the other end. I'll give you all the inflections, and you all make up your mind how you want to handle it. It's all up to you.
No wonder I've developed a frown between my eyebrows.
It's difficult, isn't it? Jimmy, would you do something while we're waiting for the slower ones? Would you give us that marvelous smile that you do?
Oh, of course.
Now sing, boy.
We should dance a little bit. See what you do there. Let's get them feet moving, boy.
He's thinner than Sammy Davis Jr.
Yes, he is.
But with as much talent.
Okay, they're all set. So, June, we call on you. Hilda called to Sally. Hey, there's a phone calls for you. There's a guy blanking up the other end.
Cussing, swearing, like, you know.
What?
Swearing.
Cussing.
She said there's a guy swearing at the other end. Jimmy, what did you say?
There's a guy at the other end.
Yeah. See, it just came to her now, breathing hard. Brett?
I've had a couple of those in my day. They're wonderful. I said inhaling because all my callers went...
Obscene call. That was an asthma attack.
Charles?
Well, when sometimes I'll call a chick and what turns her on is if it's breathing heavy.
Yeah. Okay, so alert
this. His name's Hilda, right?
Hilda. Is Hilda that... called to Sally. Hey, this phone call's for you. Does that have any significance in your answer?
Yes.
What?
Well, I think Hilda's sort of a Switzerland name. Swiss name.
Yes.
Switzerland. So, yodeling.
Oh. Yes, that's right. Is that... Listen,
you know, but that's where we're going to send you.
Is that what you had in mind, yodeling? Was that... So what did you have in mind when you wrote this question? Breathing. Oh, yeah, well, those are the good answers that are coming up.
You gotta take a deep breath to yodel.
That's right. What do you say, Richard?
Just for the future.
Yes.
Alps is a Swiss name. Just in case that ever comes up. I happen to know the guy who made the call, and he was uttering obscenities.
Uttering obscenities or swearing in the match. All right, Loretta, it's up to you.
No.
You see, Matthew?
I thought he was blowing kisses.
Blowing kisses. That's a
you haven't had a winner all
year. Any time now. You need one to match two to win. All right. Remember the song? I'm sitting on top of the world.
No.
Not the way you sing.
You don't remember
it.
Oh, dear. The song is I'm sitting on top of the world. Well,
right.
The Galloping Gourmet has a new song out called I'm sitting on top of the blank. Just rolling along. Everybody play, including you, my dear.
The world. Is that it?
That's it.
Oh, well, why didn't you sing it that way?
I'm sitting on top of the world. Just rolling along and singing a song. Hallelujah, how the folks will stare when they see that diamond solitaire that little sugar baby is gonna wear.
Did you do a musical?
That's another song, isn't it? All right, y'all ready? Okay. Beth, this is for you. Yeah, you heard the whole thing. I don't have to sing it again for
say
you, do
again.
I? Oh, you want to sing? You want me to sing it again? It's a request, folks. You remember the old song, I'm Sitting on Top of the World? Well, the Galloping Gourmet is a new song out called I'm Sitting on Top of the Blank.
Stove.
She says, I'm sitting on top of the stove is what the Galloping Gourmet's new song is called. Jimmy, what do you say?
Boss, I think this is a match, contrary to old popular belief. The oven.
Oven? Stove? Yes,
of course! You got me all the time.
Okay, Brett. There's
honey,
one.
I'd rather burn my blank than cook. Stove.
Stove wins the game. Congratulations. Stove. Well, June, it's been a pleasure meeting you and doing business with you. I hope you enjoyed it.
I did.
Good. June, we've got a gift for you, together with our thanks for being on Match Game 74. June Rose. You've got to stand by for a moment or so before we get to the big money super match. We've got to get to this. Next time we get together, we're going to start with the big money super match and see how much money that lady is going to win. And I hope you're going to be able to join us, and I hope all of you will be able to join us again. This is the first time we've had Jimmy
Walker here, who's one of the stars of a marvelous CBS show called Good Times, which is seen on Friday nights.
My new best friend.
Would you say dynamite just once?
Of course, dynamite.
Loretta, you don't come around much very often. Would you come around more often here?
I would love to.
Did you say dynamite for us?
Dynamite.
Oh, yeah, by the way, these are the celebrities we'll have next week.
Charles Nelson Reilly, Brett Summers, Don Adams, Elaine Joyce, Richard Dawson, and Mitchie McCall.
So those are the stars we'll have when we get together next time. Goodbye.